Like most people, I was attracted to the natural beauty of Belize. But since I met my friend Cadet Henderson, I'm beginning to wonder what technology it takes to run a country. Hello?
Yeah, another day in paradise. What's up, Cadet?
Hey, Steve. You ready for some more Belize technology? Let's do it.
Okay, sounds good. I'm on my way.
Welcome to this special episode of Greatest Places on Earth, entitled Belize Technology Report. My name is Steve ODell, and I'll be your host. Its purpose is to document the technological advancements to date of the young country of Belize. And special thanks goes out to the Belize Film Commission for their assistance in this project. Today you will see video of Belize technology never before seen. And I would like to take this moment and introduce you to my technical advisor, Cadet Henderson. After nearly 30 years serving as the chief engineer of the Ministry of Works, he is knowledgeable of everything Belize, and his assistance in this project has been invaluable. He will be providing commentary at the end of each segment. Now let's get started. It is the fear of many people that the way they live their lives and the food that they eat, that it will clog their arteries and cause their deaths. Now let's meet a doctor in Belize City with a brand new hospital whose job is to heal the people whose hearts have been clogged without as much as a cut. Let's watch.
Welcome to Buttonwood Bay Hospital and Cardiology Center of Belize. I'm Dr. John Goff. There are amazing things happening here every day.
Bright and shining, standing like a beacon of hope for all the people of Belize. This brand new hospital and cardiology center, Buttonwood Bay, was built for those moments in life. An expectant mother, the birth of a child, healthy and happy for life. And we understand that sometimes even the strong ones falter. And we are there every step of the way with a caring and professional staff, state-of-the-art diagnostic tools, current technology, modern medicine, and a trained, exceptional staff of professionals who were called to bring this modern and caring healthcare to the people of Belize. Through the struggles and the triumphs, the good days and the not so good, you can count on us to help you make the decisions that keep you strong. In every life, some rain must fall, and you will rest easier knowing that they are there through it all, with knowledge, compassion, and hope. Buttonwood Bay Hospital and Cardiology Center. On this day, a man's life hangs in the balance. His heart is failing, and time has all but run out. Now witness the miracle of repairing the human heart without so much as a cut, a procedure known as balloon angioplasty and stenting. The clock ticks merrily, marking the time for us before our patient, precious seconds tick away as Dr. Goff saves this man's life. This life-saving procedure has become an effective method of opening the clogged arteries of the human heart without so much as a cut. Now watch the magic of this non-invasive procedure. And now the artery is clear. This once dying man is being fitted with a pacemaker, forever steadying the beats of his heart. This man will get up and resume his life tomorrow, steady on his feet for the first time in years, healed by a technology of the present day, to live again with his beating heart. Another life saved by Dr. John Goff.
By using the most current technology, we are making improvements in our patients' lives by giving them more precious time.
And now, commentary from my technical advisor, Cadet Henderson.
Steve, you filmed live surgery there at the Buttonwood Bay Clinic, and Dr. John Goff is very famous for his life-saving procedures. No doubt many watching the show will get a good reminder that right here in Belize we can get service that is almost second to none internationally, and many foreign trained doctors work side by side with our local practitioners that have been well sought after even by foreigners coming from outside of Belize for healthcare at this facility.
Now here's a segment about an extraordinary job that's necessary to keep Belize moving. You'll love this.
Hello, my name is George Orellana, Honor Director of Belize Marine and Mooring Services Limited. Our services consist in mooring and unmooring vessels at the Belize Port Limited. We also offering mooring and unmooring oil tankers at the Puma facility. We also offering barge services to all the islands off the coast of Belize. Today, we are going to see a typical day for our crew members. Let's take a look at it.
Every day, these guys are revving up their engines and churning out a wake. Today, their job is to bring in this container ship so it can be unloaded at the Port of Belize. Sounds simple, huh? No way! Can you imagine starting your day like this? That was the easy part. This is man's work, and the boss man is right there doing his part. The tugboat is nosing up to the container ship, waiting for instructions from the bridge. Yeah, that's right, it's time to push. Cause you see, these big ships can't maneuver like this. That's the job that these guys do. It's all about taking control. These ships are close enough to touch and there's no room for mistakes. 265,000 tons of ship and cargo that needs to be tied down and unloaded, muy pronto. Maybe you'll be lucky enough to be a line handler on the boss man's boat. Now get down on your belly and reach for that line. Do it quick before the boat gets bashed against the back of the ship. The boss man is watching and the pressure is on. It's all in a day's work for these guys. Now throw the line up to the next man. Get it right first time. This is serious business. And when she's all tied down, roll up your ropes and throw them back on the boat. And now for the graceful dismount that we've all waited for. Watch your step. The first one's a doozy. Good job, man. It's like this every day to keep things moving at the Port of Belize. The boss man looks like he's pleased. Now take a break. You've earned it. Another day, same job, but a little bit different. Today, the crew of Belize Marine and Mooring Services are bringing in an oil tanker to unload at the Puma facility. The boss man is right there and the tug is pushing his little heart out. These oil tankers are monsters, and it'll take a while to get her in position and tied down. This is an important client. Puma is a respected oil company. And it looks like the sailors appreciate the help of Belize Marine and Mooring Services. And here is more commentary from our technical advisor, Cadet Henderson. Cadet?
Those footage you show of George Orellana and his tugboat bringing in the ships to Port of Belize, that's amazing. George is my personal friend, and it's wonderful to see him dominating the business. Seaboard Marine, I know he brings in all their ships every week, and they have an excellent safety record, and it's always a pleasure seeing his boats in action and seeing these foreign ships dock safely at our port.
Staying cool in the Belizean heat is a joy indeed. Now here's a segment that I call the Air Conditioning King. What do these buildings have in common? Brody's, Save You, the Bellican Brewery, First Caribbean Bank, Scotia Bank, the American Embassy, Sagicor, Servitec. What they have in common is all of these buildings had their air conditioning installed by F.T. Williams and Associates. They are number one in Belize, and now that we have your attention, let's take a look at some of their ongoing projects. First, let's fly to San Pedro. We should have known when Tropic Air laid out the red carpet for us that we would be touring one of their buildings. So there we were, me, Cadet, F.T. Williams, and five of his best men. And at a glance, we knew that this project was special. Meet the new VRF air conditioning technology.
This is a new technology that we're using here in Belize now, that our company has adopted. It comes pre-wired from the factory. That way we don't have to buy a brand new disconnect. So we save on cables, and this is a very good system where you can actually check the consumption to make sure that BEL is not taking advantage of us, no, the consumers. Everything All these black wires is what we did. And everything down here is what was pre-wired already.
Excellent. First time I'm seeing one like this.
Yeah, well, I can tell you we have to keep on top of technology. From here, it feeds the main distribution. The main distribution actually feeds the air conditioning upstairs, you know, and that's where it gets its power from. This is actually the main distribution panel for the upstairs. It also feeds the distribution panel downstairs, which then feeds all the different panels for outlets, lights, and air conditioning.
So in the event there's a power failure, what time lag is there before the system trips in?
It takes between 5 and 10 seconds. It will sense power loss from BEL. It will send a signal to the generator to come on. It will transfer power in 5 to 10 seconds. And that's all the time that you will lose without power.
Impressive. That's within what the U.S. Embassy requirements were in Belize.
Right. Well, we actually work there too, so.
I approved the plan, so I saw the specs.
Very nice. Very nice.
So let's hear from the client, John E. Grief.
Hello, my name is Johnny Grief. I'm the president of Tropic Air. We're the domestic airline here in Belize, and we're based in San Pedro. Our local electricity is quite expensive. It's about 25 cents kW, about 25 cents a kilowatt hour. So we have to seek efficiency in everything we do. One of our primary draws for electricity is air conditioning. When F.T. Williams and Company first approached us about a VRF air conditioning system, we were initially a little skeptical because the cost is quite high. But after analyzing the system, we realized it would actually save us money. And in practice, that's what's happened. To give you an example, the building we're in now is 7,000 square feet, fully insulated, R40 in the ceiling, R20 in the walls, R5 in the glass. Our old building across the street is 2,000 square feet and uninsulated. It uses old technology, although relatively high-tech air conditioning with two-phase compressors. And our electric bill on this building is the same as on that one. It's 2.5 times bigger. So we have a real-world, easy example of how the VRF and the high-tech in general saves money.
Now let's hear from the president of the company, F.T. Williams himself.
Welcome to the world of technology, the greatest unit invented for air conditioning applications. And of course, we're here with the brand new VRF technology that has been installed here at the Tropic Building in San Pedro. And it's done by our company, F.T. Williams & Associates. We are basically the only company in the country that is certified, trained to install and commission these systems. And let me tell you this, they're not only so efficient, they're environmentally safe. They used environmentally sound refrigerant, R410A, with super technology in it. And I'm telling you this, the owner were so impressed with our first project we did with VRF. They told us that the savings were about 60%. So they decide, you know what, on this large project, let us go back and we're going to go VRF. And of course, only by F.T. Williams certified install with the only professional company in Belize.
Now we're back in Belize City at their Refrigitech location to learn more about what F.T. Williams can offer to you.
You see, we're not just an installation company. We also have a department which deals exclusively with sales. It's called Refrigitech Belize. We are the dealers for TGM air conditioners, which we use for residential installations. And for commercial installations, we have our line of units called York. You can buy any unit here and we guarantee that we're going to have parts. We're going to have after market support for you. If you want an air conditioner done right, installed right, you come here, you buy it from Refrigitech Belize. F.T. Williams will install it for you.
Owning your own home in Belize is a dream that we all share. Now let's meet a very likable man who calls himself the contractor for the rich and the poor. It's exciting having something built that's all yours, your own place here in sunny Belize. If you try to do it yourself, it's way too complicated. You need a contractor that does this every day. Someone who can help you save money. Someone you can trust. Someone nice. Humberto Blanco is all these things. He is trusted by the biggest names in Belize, and he loves to build homes and businesses, like this huge home built for a Taiwanese family in Belmopan, picture perfect, or this very cute family home built for this nice lady in Belmopan. She wanted something pretty yet practical, suburban yet secure. Whatever you want, he'll build it for you. Now let's meet some of Mr. Blanco's clients and see what they have to say.
Hi, we are using Mr. Blanco to build our house here in Benque Viejo del Carmen. He is a really good constructor. We have been working with him for the past years, and he has a lot of patience. So I fully recommend him to do your house whenever you're ready to build one.
These guys started on time. They stayed within budget, and the project was done within the time frame. There was no surprises, no hidden surprises. There were no price creep at the end of this project. I also received, at the end of each phase, I received a detailed step-by-step report from the contractor that I had to submit to the bank. And by submitting that, I got myself the disbursement immediately. There was no problem at all. I am happy with my house. If you have seen clips of it, I just love going home. That is my castle.
Okay guys, you could see what I could offer to you on buildings that would be affordable for the poor and the rich. With my colleague Henderson Cadet, we could make sure that he design and I build. You could see on my logo the email address and my cell number. You could contact me 24 hours.
And here is more commentary from my technical advisor, Cadet Henderson. Cadet?
Yeah, we are here at the site of the SSS Tiabo building here in Belmopan. This is one of the largest edifices under construction in this part of the country. And this one in particular has a basement where an entire store is below ground. I'll send you some pictures of some of the technology that went into ensuring that it is properly dewatered. We have French drains, we have kickers for all the vertical elements, such as the walls and the columns, in combination with a bright yellow water stop or water bar. And even the toilets, when it flushes, it's well below the septic tank, so we have sumps that bring sewage effluent up to the surface to the tanks, as well as we have a secondary sump in the unlikely event that the building becomes inundated, where pumps would automatically lift that collection up to the city drains.
Get ready to see the inner workings of the biggest telecommunications company in Belize. Roll the tape. In Belize, we have our own kind of beat. 350,000 Belizeans with places to go and people to see. And the one thing that keeps us connected is our phones.
My name is Gail Odell, Public Relations Officer at Belize Telemedia Limited. Belize Telemedia Limited is the largest full-service nationalized telecommunication company in the country. We provide the latest and cutting-edge technology to all our customers.
Everyone knows that they are the biggest telecommunications company in Belize, but there is much that you don't know, like the technology that makes this all possible. We'll see this today.
Hi, my name is Renan Bernard. I'm a switch technician for Belize Telemedia Limited. Welcome to my world. With the advancement in technology, we now have fiber, which can do almost anything, transport data, voice, video, at much higher speeds with much more capacity. Above us is where we have gigabits of information passing through our advanced fiber network to the 4G network. And on my left here, 4G data network, where we have the most advanced equipment in the country. We also have the most advanced mobile packet backbone network in the entire country of Belize.
Hi, good afternoon everyone. My name is David Price Jr. Presently, I'm a supervisor for broadband services here at lovely BTL, the beautiful country of Belize. I'd like to speak briefly on the way our broadband services has evolved over the years. Initially, we started with dial-up services, and we've reached a point where we have high-speed bandwidth offered to several customers countrywide. We have customers with as high a bandwidth of 150 megs. Those are corporate customers. We have customers with residential links that go as high as probably 16 megs. That's very high bandwidth, and customers can do as much as they want to those services. Presently, we offer wireless and internet services to about 90% of the country. We offer services in the rural areas, high-speed internet in the rural areas. We offer it in the Keys, in the North, in the South, in the East and West. We have evolved to have 3 different links to our international providers in the event of any major failures. If we have a link, if you are going to America, we have redundant services. If we have a failure to the North, we have additional links. So we've come a long way. Other than our broadband services, we also have mobile services, which is the 4G service. And the 4G service, as most people know, is internet on your phone. And that allows, that is mainly used right now by the kids. A lot of high schoolers and sixth formers and university students use that, and they find it helpful in their studies. They're able to do research at the click of a button. They're able to improve on their life skills and have education at their fingertips. So BTL has come a long way. We are at a point where we offer free internet to schools countrywide, to all the primary schools and high schools. So it's a service that the company does for free. We don't make a lot of noise about it, but it's something that I think we should spread the word and have everyone understand that the company, being a local company, we do give back. We are now moving forward to offering Wi-Fi in the park. That is a program that all parks countrywide, or not all parks countrywide rather, but the main parks countrywide would have wireless internet for at least for let's say for BTL customers, that a resident in that area could go at that park and access the internet for free, can do research, can do homework, can, you know, go on Facebook, watch a YouTube video, relax, just free up themselves. And that's all a gift from BTL. So I like you guys to just consider those stuff, and whenever you know anyone that wants to buy internet service, refer them to BTL. At BTL, we have you covered.
Well, Steve, here we are at what is called the Monopalm at the National Agriculture and Trade Show location here in Belmopan. This is one of its kind in Belize. This is a monopole with foliage that actually have simulated vinyl leaves on the structure. This structure, I've designed one like this 10 years ago that was never built, but I designed this one a couple years ago and it was built. I'm happy to see it there. Many find it intriguing that here you have a structure that looks like a tree, and that actually have the antenna and the relay system for a regular cell site. As you know, BTL have been around from the days of cable and wireless, where they transitioned after the first system was set up back in the late 70s. But this is one of many to come, and many would say it's environmentally friendly. It blends in with the vegetation, with the landscaping, and I look forward to see many more of these being built around the country.
And now let's meet a gentleman who is planting trees in Belize, a very special tree called the neem tree, and with it, an opportunity for everyone involved.
Good afternoon, we're in sunny Belize. I'm here to explain to you about the neem tree. Its reputation as a cure-all tree has been known in its local regions for centuries. The rest of the world is awakening to the realization that this tree, from its roots to its tip, hold potential secrets that can cure many, many diseases. The product can be used for many industries. Agriculture, for instance, there is biopesticides, insecticides, organic pesticides and high effective fertilizers. The cosmetic industry, there are many products made from toothpaste to soaps to facial creams. The demand for green alternatives is growing for the pharmaceutical and farming industries as people demand natural solutions. The medical industry, there are cures for mosquito bites, HIV and AIDS is a new product that they're looking at to stave off the symptoms of AIDS. The neems can grow up to 100 feet tall, live for a couple hundred years producing their fruits. It's been known for centuries about their medical and agricultural properties. Farmers discovered this through nature and develop technologies to utilize the trees to protect their livestock and their land. I'm offering this unique opportunity to become part of this development in the coastal area of Belize, planting neem plantations, which helps the environment and helps the local populace. Investing in neem minimizes your risk because it's sellable in many markets. The current phase is 100 acres of land we're cultivating. We have many packages of various sizes to maximize your returns on your investment. I invite you to contact us to find out how you can take part in this unique opportunity.
And here is more commentary from our technical advisor, Cadet Henderson. Cadet?
Yeah, Steve, that area your colleague is referring to where he plans to grow neem, I think is an area that may be ideal. Without knowing information about the soil, I do know that the White Ridge Farm is right near to Gales Point Manatee, and that's a location that is near the largest mango farm in the world. I'm doing a project right in vicinity right now and had the chance to do boreholes in several locations, and from the type of vegetation that is native to the area and the fruits and vegetables that I've seen growing in the area, I think it's a good location.
And now let's take a tour of the Bee Call Dams. Prepare to be amazed. The Moleon Hydroelectric Power Station is the first of three dams owned and operated by Belize Electric Company Limited. Located in the Cayo District, these dams are amazing engineering feats designed to produce electricity to feed a growing nation. Today you will get a glimpse behind the scenes in the operation of these three amazing hydroelectric dams while we enjoy nature and a sunny day in this beautiful park-like setting. Enjoy the tour. The Molihon uses a proven technology known as run-of-the-river hydroelectric generation, which means a portion of the river's flow is diverted into an underground power tunnel. This water is sent downhill, picking up speed. Its force is used to turn the generators, creating electricity. Afterwards, the water joins back with the river. The Vaca Hydroelectric Facility is the newest of the three Bee Call Dams. With a reservoir up to 150 feet deep, this beautiful 170-acre lake extends 4 kilometers up the McCall River. And what a sight, standing atop the crest of this dam. From this dizzying height, we can see everything as our eyes follow the water escaping back into the mighty McCall. After a brief moment to look around, we drove down to the powerhouse, where we observed electricity on its way out to homes all over Belize. Cadet was in his element as he spoke with Oscar, recalling the construction of these dams. The water churned as it escaped the Vaca turbines and rushed down the tail race. As for us, we were heading into the powerhouse to get a closer look at the technology that made all this possible. So down, down we went. Places that few eyes have ever seen. From the Vaca control room, the plant operator uses state-of-the-art control systems to monitor and access the operations of all three dams simultaneously. Working with a crew of engineers and electricians, there is truly a lot going on here, as you can see. But for us, we were going further down to the generator floor. The roar of these generators is deafening, as two 9,000 kilowatt generators and one 1,000 kilowatt generator crank out the energy. I filmed the startup of one of these generators. Take a look. These are big machines kicking out the power, heading to BEL and running safe. As we continued our tour, we saw machines designed to back up other machines and systems with fail-safes to monitor the dams, ensuring that all was well. And enough technology to boggle the mind. This is a big deal, and I was surely impressed. You can't imagine how many rooms and passageways are down there. So cool. When we arrived at Chilio, it looked like something out of an oil painting. So beautiful. We were going to take a boat tour of the reservoir, and I was excited. Surrounded by the Maya Mountains and the Pine Ridge, we were alone in a paradise, exploring this huge 2,500-acre reservoir. From the backside, the view of this dam is magnificent and so humbling that men could work together and create a system of dams like this, harnessing the power of nature to feed the energy needs of a growing nation. As the sun set on my time with the men of BCAL, I felt inspired to do more with my life. How about you? And here is more commentary from my technical advisor, Cadet Henderson. Cadet?
Hey Steve, we made that grand tour of Baca Falls, the Mollejon and the Chalio Dam. I'll send you some pictures when I was there during the construction and even pre-construction. But that was very impressive. As most of us know, the Chalio Dam facility is really the reservoir facility that schedules water that is used for both the Chalio, the Mollejon, and the Baca Dam. And the technology there is amazing. A lot of the principles that applies to the big dams elsewhere in the world have been applied right there. The water is scheduled, it's rationed for the dry season. There's a penstock, for example, that ensure that even though you have a cost-effective dam structure on the river, you get almost double the head where the powerhouse comes out a couple miles downstream of where the main dam is. And so we've seen all the intricacies of the dam, the system for monitoring and for emergency response. Many Belizeans don't know that if there is ever a crisis situation at the dam, the system is programmed such that individuals will receive a text message. And so let's see some more on the technology.
In the unfortunate event of a health emergency, you need to know where to go in advance. This video will help. When you or someone you love has been hurt, you'll do whatever it takes to save them. And in that split second, you need to know where to go. Belize Healthcare Partners Limited in Belize City is ready for that emergency. Their trained staff are standing by to get you through this tough time. And when everything is all right, you'll be glad that you chose them.
I'm Dr. Jorge Hidalgo. I'm an internist and adult intensivist. And I want to talk to you about the critical care services that we offer at Belize Healthcare Partners. And whether if you are coming in a helicopter to our helipad, or if you are coming in an ambulance, as you already seen, the initial phase of a critical ill patient is our emergency room. At the emergency room, we have it's a shock trauma where basically we have equipment like defibrillator, we have a continuous monitoring, invasive and non-invasive. We have portable X-ray equipment. It's very accessible to our CT room, where the patient can be easily transported in case of a CT need to be done while the patient are stable. We have a transport ventilators also for us to be easily move one patient from the emergency room to the CT room or to be transported to the intensive care unit. The Belize Healthcare Partners Intensive Care Unit is the oldest one in the country and is a total of 6-bed ICU. We can handle 6 patients at the same time. And we have a team, and our team consists of respiratory therapists. We have nurses that are trained on intensive care. And also we have a supportive team consists of several specialists. We have neurosurgeon services, we have a cardiology services, gastroenterology services, and we have a trauma surgeon also that can support us in the management of these seriously ill patients.
And here is more commentary from my technical advisor, Cadet Henderson. Cadet?
Steve, I've known Dr. Vinny for many years, and his hospital, the private hospital in Belize City, Belize Healthcare Partners Limited, is doing very well at giving Belizeans an alternative, as well as expatriate Belizeans, and even visiting visitors and tourists from abroad. I know go there. They've been gaining quite some grounds with the effectiveness of their emergency room and the special care that they provide for dialysis patients. In fact, many have described to me that some dialysis patients go there who cannot afford the services, but they still get the best treatment.
And now let's hear from one of Belize's telecommunication companies and the good work that they're doing. In a very short time, Smart has become a leading mobile service provider in Belize, constantly providing affordable, reliable, and innovative communication solutions that improve the lives of their customers. Thanks to their hard work and dedication, Smart is known for delivering first-class telecom services, nationwide coverage, low prices, more support, and faster access to the Internet. Today, 300,000 Belizeans have cell phones, and Smart is proud to be part of this revolution. Making communication widely available and more affordable than ever, Smart has steadily grown and established themselves as a dependable alternative, bringing much-needed competition to the industry in Belize. Having invested over $60 million over the past 10 years, this company has garnered over 30% of the market and looks forward to investing more to expand their opportunities in Belize. And Smart gives back to the people of Belize. I personally filmed a soccer tournament in Belize City where all uniforms were donated by Smart. These kids were happy, playing their little hearts out, learning about good sportsmanship, good health, and just having fun. What goes around comes around. A better life for our kids, thanks to Smart.
Yeah, Smart!
And here is more commentary from my technical advisor, Cadet Henderson. Cadet?
This is one of the many recent installations for the SpeedNet smart communication system. This is a cell site recently commissioned, and there are several around the country, and I think just this year they celebrated their 10th anniversary. Smart is doing well in complementing their bigger competitor that dominates telecommunications in Belize, but they combined add to the reliability of telecommunication service in Belize, and this is quite a welcome expansion of their network.
The biggest contractor in Belize is about to show you how it's done. Big, big, big.
Hello, my name is Lee Van Chan. I work for Medina's Construction as project manager on this unique project we're building here in San Pedro. It's a ferroconcrete building with a prefab structure on it. It's gonna be used for airplane maintenance. It's to accommodate five full-size caravans during maintenance, full-time, 24 hours a day. The building is basically comprised of a pile foundation with a concrete slab. The portion at the front, 300 feet long by 17 feet wide, is going to be used for office in general and parts department. The other section, which is the open section, which has a covered canopy of 60 feet long and wide by 300 feet long. This is a unique structure. It actually came from the UK. Why the uniqueness is because we have never seen the type of galvanized that we have ordered for this building. It's the normal galvanized, the Hadeep galvanized, comes at an 80 micron thickness. This is 146. Why we order this is because of the salt air here in San Pedro. Apart from that, we have our maintenance ramps comprised of ferroconcrete reinforced with rebars. All the quality controls have been taken care of on this project. They are monitored strictly to comply with the specifications.
And then we were off on our tour. At first glance, we could see the vision behind this building. It's modern design, the best of everything, with Belizeans doing the work. Yeah, this project was coming together and Medina's men were behind it all the way. This is a high-profile project. Tropic Air is a well-respected company in Belize. Being the major contractor on a building project like this speaks volumes about the credibility and professionalism of Medina's construction company. Yeah, they're big. Probably the biggest in Belize.
We're on the Mirab site, Belize City. We are working on this project. This is a new Mirab. My name is Ramon Katsim. I'm the project manager in charge of this project, an engineer. I work for Mr. David Medina for Medina's construction. Let's go take a look.
With scaffolding reaching to the sky, the new Mirab building is one of the most talked about construction projects going on right now in Belize City. This multi-story building is big, 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 and the concrete work is major construction on the grandest scale. We found it interesting to learn that Medina's construction company is using a technology that they bought in Italy to build concrete rafters unique to Belize. This is hard work that these men do, and somewhat dangerous too, but these guys are a determined crew who are great at what they do, all put in place by David Medina himself.
We're here at the Douglas Jones Canal Project. My name is Abner Urbina, the site engineer for David Medina. We're building the deepest canal here at Belize City, which starts from Douglas Jones Street and ends in Newtown Barracks, right beside the Princess Hotel. We're really proud of this project. Come, let's take a look.
Being chosen by the Ministry of Works to handle an issue as sensitive as flood control is another bell ringer demonstrating the trust that is put into Medina's construction company. But hey, we were already impressed. This canal system passes through neighborhoods and in and around roadways. The obstacles in their path are ever changing, but this crew is focused on bringing this huge project to completion.
Hi, this is the last site we are visiting. We are working for Mr. David Medina for a company named Medina's Construction. We are very proud to be building this project here. It's a new sugar factory for the group Santander. Let's take a look at what we are doing.
There is no other way to say it. The Santander Sugar Factory project is incredible. Building a functioning sugar factory in the middle of a sea of cane fields is the most talked about project in Belize this year. And for good reason. There are things going on here like you've never seen before. Taking shape, we saw ramps to load the cane, to squeeze the cane, to cut the cane, to catch the juice, all part of a process on the biggest scale imaginable.
Yeah, I'm over 60,000.
There are structures here chocked full of engineering technology, and there are hundreds of workers on the site. Medina was in charge of the concrete, formed to support huge weight, as heavy duty as you can imagine it.
You are looking at 200 cubic yards of concrete for the base of the chimney and for the 8 anchor bolts precisely placed. These columns and anchor bolts has to be built very precise.
And yes, we saw the Italian ceiling forms that Medina is known for. We were taken to the warehouse to see more concrete work, and then the tour continued.
These are the channels we made. They are used to recirculate the water that wash the fumes from the chimney to avoid pollution to the environment.
Did you know that this factory will produce electricity and send it back into the grid? There are many amazing things going on here. Medina's construction company is helping to change Belize for the better. And here is more commentary from my technical advisor, Cadet Henderson. Cadet?
Steve, in regards to Medina's construction, that contractor is definitely a foremost construction authority in this country. There are four projects that he has ongoing, and I've had the chance to tour all four in recent times. In regards to the canal that Medina is doing, I personally toured the sites. And I'm quite familiar with the package since some of it was bundled from I was at Ministry of Works. The project he's doing in San Pedro, which is a very significant addition to the Tropic Care facility with that hangar. With the technology they are using there with the floor system, the steel frame, and the air conditioning system, it was an honor for me to be there in regards to what the involvement he has there at Santander, which is a major $300 million facility. Mr. Medina, I designed a communication tower there. I'm even designing a bridge that will span the Belize River that will be the main access to the Santander sugar facility. But Mr. Medina is definitely making his mark in Belize.
And to tie this all together, here's an American lady whose passion is to connect Belizean business people with American business people. Let's watch.
Well, 10 years ago, we came to Belize on our first trade mission. We've been coming to Belize. We've made over 12 trade missions, bringing at least 15 to 20 people, and that's a little over 200 people that we have introduced to Belize. And we have a delegation of anywhere between 10 to 15 people who are business owners in the U.S. that comes here to Belize looking for different opportunities. Our business owners are very, very diverse, from service, construction, training, medical field, also health, preventive health. And so there's a lot that we understand that can be utilized here. We come here as partners, not as individual businesses seeking individual opportunities. We are looking for the opportunities to partner with someone here, preferably Belizeans. And we term our mission as a business development mission with the idea of partnering for economic empowerment. We realize and we believe, and what we've seen is that Belize has natural resources. We, on the other hand, have other resources, and combining the natural resources to resources that's business related, we see where the empowerment can really benefit the economy, not just here, but from where we are, and the sustainable development here in Belize. Can we do one big more round of applause? I can tell you where their heart is. They're really here. Delegates, hold your hands up. So now we're Belizeans.
And here is more commentary from my technical advisor, Cadet Henderson. Cadet?
Yes, Steve, I know Leandra Thompson very well. She's out of Houston, Texas, and she's been to Belize scores of times. For many years, she's been communicating with me on her visits. She's also a trade ambassador to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and has brought through some successful diaspora Belizeans as well as foreigners, Americans who live in Texas that have interest in investing in Belize. And I know of contracts that have been signed and land acquisition and major industries that are about to be set up because of her participation in bringing these investors to our country.
Well, that's all that we have for this episode of Greatest Places on Earth, Belize Technology Report. If you would like to appear on a future episode, feel free to contact us at BelizeTechReport@outlook.com. Until then, thank you and enjoy this beautiful Belize.
Hey Steve.
Hey Cadet.
How did the show go?
Yeah, it was great. We're rolling credits right now.
It was a lot of fun, huh?
It was amazing.
You ready for some more Belize technology? Let's do it.
Sounds good. I'm on my way.